want everybody to be wonderful to see all of me. Personally, I believe in the Floyd case because I've dealt with Stop-and-Frisk issues on a personal basis. Just from Tuesday night, me and two of my friends were stopped after we were on the party. Soon after they stopped us, they were summoned to us. Less than 2 blocks later, we got stopped again by a patent bag. Four officers came out and asked us again. The only reason why we didn't get other summons or things didn't transpire because of the summons that just seemed less than a minute prior. And these are the policies that have been lasting 4 years that panel, Floyd versus City of New York, first class action lawsuit on a federal level challenging the issue that they are violating constitutional rights, such as the 4th Amendment and the 14th Amendment, all dealing with racial profiling and legal service proceedings. So we're making a lot of momentum, a lot of people being aware of this, and hopefully as this case goes on, more people will start to come together. Some other individuals who might not know that we are coming together, doing things that we are, that there are people that are working for change. A lot of people used to say, you know, well, us protesting was that going to do, but we have something in federal court that we actually are happy, we are starting to make up, and happy to be a part of this movement.
Which also is really important is the hygiene bill with sensitive and normal.
go to the homeland site and fill it out and be a part of this thing right now. It is my pleasure to introduce the state controller who just stepped in the building, John
Yeah. I represent Justice Committee. What is Justice Committee? Justice Committee is an Latino, Latino-led-based organization dealing with two things. We're trying to build a movement against police violence and systemic issues regarding racism in New York City. Because racism looks like a lot of things. Ticket fixing, Stop-and-Frisk, clean halls. We can go on forever talking about what it means. But I have three individuals with me today, and we're going to talk about something that's very important. What is Cop Watch? What is Cop Watch? Cop Watch is a legal documentation and recording of police activity. That's right, ladies and gentlemen. I said it. Believe it or not, it's legal. It's completely legal, regardless of what that person says to that piece of item on their chest. What's that called? Oh, that's right, a badge. No matter what that person says, and says, this is legal, I will arrest you, I will take you down. It's completely legal. It is in your constitutional right to say, I have the right to record and document your activity. What are you doing to that person? What are you doing? And if it's not legal, I have you on camera, and I have to go before a judge and let them know why I have evidence against you. So I have here my brother right here. Antonio, talk about all the services that we provide. Know your rights. We provide cop watch training. We provide family support for those who have been affected by this disgusting practice of stop, question, and frisk. Antonio, please.
Good evening, everyone. Say good evening, everyone. I too am a part of the Justice Committee and the People's Defense, right, and also the Cop Watch. We do Cop Watch in different neighborhoods of the Bronx, but we have this located in the borough of the Bronx and any borough of New York City. So if you have any friends outside of the Bronx, please tell them about it. Go on the website, Justice Committee, and find out more information about that. But as my brother Rico was just sharing, it's very important to understand what Cop Watch is. Okay, it can affect all of us, not just as individuals, but our family members, friends, people of that age. It's very important to understand what your rights are and to invoke them. Does everyone know what their rights are? Okay, well, the first thing I want to inform you about is what to say whenever a police officer uses discrimination or racial profiling in your neighborhood. Anytime they want to stop and frisk you, the first thing you should say to them is, am I being detained? Am I being arrested? Am I free to leave? Invoke your rights. It's very important. It's most important to inform your children. Because police officers have what's called a quorum. Every moment is supposed to meet that. And if you get your resume at, they can do it and tell you more money. So it's very important to understand the power of your children, how to invoke their rights. They don't necessarily need any police officer questions whenever they're being interrogated. So that's just one thing I want to share with you. Also, please feel free to network with people in this environment right now. You'd be surprised how many people you can learn to know what they can inform. In addition to that, I would also like to tell you that we have a passion on Mondays for Bronx.
I am a member of the community who cares about the community. because I see the concrete difference that it makes. We have observed stops where police were on the verge of putting their hands on someone illegally. But the second that they see 10 of us with those cop box shirts on and our cameras out, they think twice.
You know, you're aware, but I'm so proud, and I'm brother, Thank you. Yeah, just try to type it in the search. That shit was over.
Found out that in the survey there were 4,882 stops. community member and part of the Water Justice Project, and did most of the analyses with me that Jackie was talking about in terms of this community survey in 40 blocks just north of here. Collected 1,030 surveys, and we asked a lot of questions about what it means to be police in the neighborhood and attitudes towards the police. So I just want to, you all know, you all can probably guess what the information says, but I just want to sort of reaffirm what our survey says. We asked if you've been stopped by police in your lifetime, and our survey said that of the 1,030 people who took our survey, 89% said that they had a person, 75% said they had been police sometime in their life. 75% of our survey. One of the most shocking statistics is that of those who have been stopped, 25 were stopped for the first time in 13 years or younger. We asked what percentage of people have been stopped by police in the last year. 69% of the people who took our survey said they were stopped for the last year. 52% were stopped four or more times. 60% of the people who took our survey were asked to move. 56% were asked to show ID. It is not a law, it is not mandatory to carry ID in New York State, nor is it a law or mandatory to have to show your ID to the NYPD in New York State. We found out that about half of our sample have been given a ticket or arrested, but the shocking statistic is that of those who were arrested, 46% were dismissed in court, and 57% were dismissed in court if we were given a ticket or a summons. We already know of the nearly 5,000 stops in this neighborhood, 93% of those stops were innocent. They were not arrested, they were not given a ticket or a summons. To slow it down. My fault. One more thing I want to share with you. We also learned that 43% of the people who took our survey reported that they had called the police for help last year. But the shocking statistics here are that 16% of the time the police never came. 59% of the time the police came late. And 42% of the time the police arrived 30 minutes from late. A number of the people in our research group said they could watch an entire sitcom by the time that some of that police would actually arrive. Only 35% of the time, only 31% of the time did people say that when the police did arrive, they were helpful. And only 27% of the time did they say that when the police arrived, they were respected. Which again is a shocking statistic. So I'm going to turn it over to some other folks in the War Justice Project to read some of the quotes that we received from the survey.
Carrying this neighborhood to have a police village of neighborhood in New York State. And you can see the difference in how people So check it out.